It seems you can't turn on the TV or scroll through your Facebook feed without seeing a story about sexual harassment. The latest hashtag, MeToo, encourages women to step up and speak out if they've ever been a victim. And it's been one of the top trending hashtags for days now. The problem has been around since women joined the workforce, but never before has it been so publicly exposed and examined. And one of the reasons is Minnesota native Gretchen Carlson, whose own sexual discrimination suit against powerful Fox TV executive Roger Ailes sparked a national conversation. We sat down with Gretchen in Dubuque, Iowa, before her speech to a women's group there, to talk about her new book, just released today, and about becoming the reluctant face of a movement.
Listen, every morning I wake up, I don't say, wow, I'm really glad I'm the face of this.
If Minnesota native Gretchen Carlson is a bit uncomfortable with her new role fighting sexual harassment, it's understandable. Her sex discrimination lawsuit 15 months ago thrust her into an unplanned chapter of an otherwise meticulously planned life. A life that started in Anoka, Minnesota, where at 6 years old, she set her first goal to become a concert violinist. By 13, she was invited to perform a solo with the Minnesota Orchestra. She then set a goal to become Miss America and was crowned in 1989 at the age of 22. And just listen to what she told our Pat Miles shortly after her reign ended.
Well, what about the television career? That's your next goal.
I want to be on national television and be one of the hosts on a morning show.
In 2005, she became co-host of the network morning news show, Fox and Friends. But that chapter abruptly ended when she was terminated from the network, fired, she claimed, in a bombshell lawsuit because she refused the sexual advances of the powerful head of the network, Roger Ailes.
Like making a decision to jump off a cliff like that with no idea if you have a safety net below or not is the most difficult professional decision I ever made in my life. Maybe the most difficult decision at all in my life.
The backlash was swift and vicious, but just 2 short weeks after she filed, Roger Ailes was fired and Carlson received a $20 million settlement.
What was it like to watch that from your perspective?
I had no idea what to expect. Every day has been surreal.
Since then, Carlson has been working toward a new goal, defending other women who've been harassed in the workplace.
On the first day, at least 20 women reached out to me, and then it grew to the hundreds, and then it grew to the thousands. My Midwestern sensibilities again told me I had to do something with this.
So she decided to give them a voice by compiling their stories in a book titled Be Fierce, which also provides a playbook for victims.
You can't just one day suddenly decide, I can't take this anymore, and I'm going to go file a complaint, because you can't put the genie back in the bottle.
Not surprisingly, Carlson emphasizes the need to have a plan.
You need to consult a lawyer, even just for a first conversation, to get advice on how to handle
it. Before you go to your HR
department. Before you go to HR.
But filing a successful complaint is just one piece of the puzzle. Many employment contracts have a clause that forces employees to take their complaints before a company-appointed arbitrator.
You find out that you have a clause that's taken away your Seventh Amendment right to a jury trial, and that if you do file a claim, no one's ever going to know about it. You're probably going to get fired, and the perpetrator is probably going to be able to stay in the workplace and continue harassing women.
Carlson argues the forced secrecy, often part of arbitration agreements, is meant to protect company trade secrets and has no place in discrimination suits. That is why she's lobbying Congress to pass a bipartisan bill that would bring discrimination complaints into the light.
This is the tipping point.
Though she couldn't have planned on the avalanche of women coming forward since she first jumped off that cliff, she's found her work on this unplanned chapter of her life immensely rewarding.
If I played any role in giving those women the courage to also stand up and say this is not right, then I'm immensely proud.
And Gretchen does hope to someday go back into television news. She said she still feels she has a lot to offer, but right now this advocacy work has become a full-time job. So certainly a lot of eyes and ears pointed in her direction lately. Yeah.
Really an interesting interview that you said.
Yeah, she's a smart woman and you know, regardless of your political views or what you think of her or what happened at Fox News, I mean, it's a really important topic and she's getting the word out. So more power
to
her.
Absolutely.